There are about 3,500 different qualities of steel. And since it's used in so many applications, it's actually quite hard to imagine a world without steel. Steel plays a fundamental role in the modern society. We use about 1.8 billion tons of steel every year. Some of it you see, for example, in cars and electronics, and some of it you don't see, which is in the infrastructure, in buildings and elsewhere. Thanks to its wide variety of features, it's very popular to use, and it's also recyclable in a way that many other materials are not. When you make steel, you start with iron ore. And iron ore is iron and oxygen, and you need a sort of glue to get rid of the oxygen. And that glue has since the beginning been carbon. So to produce a ton of steel, you need more than half a ton of carbon. The carbon you use in the present process of steelmaking ends up as carbon dioxide. So the global production of iron and steel leads to 7% of the global CO2 emissions. So every ton of steel made generates 1.8 ton of CO2 emissions. Steel is needed and will continue to be needed as population grows and people move increasingly into cities, which drives a need for more infrastructure. The unique thing about HYBRIT is that we, for the first time in the history of iron and steel making, replace the carbon with hydrogen. Hydrogen made from fossil-free electricity. And the only byproduct you get from that is water. Replacing coal with hydrogen from electricity in this way will have enormous positive impact, but it will also require a lot of electricity. And that's why Vattenfall, SSAB and LKAB has partnered up for this. It's a huge undertaking and it's a societal change, so therefore we need to work together. It has the potential to reduce the Swedish CO2 emissions by 10% and the Finnish emissions by 7%. If you compare fossil-free steel with today's conventional steel, you will not really notice any difference in the properties, how it looks and how it behaves in different applications. The big difference is that it didn't cause any emissions in its making, and therefore you can look at it as an invisible revolution.